Good morning, students. Welcome to this video. Previous class we will discuss about the Tigetanian grass eating animals. You know, so the digestion process is common for multicellular organism to single cellular organism. You know, so it is a common for all living organisms. Okay, so the some organisms you cannot see in your eyes. Okay, so what is that organism? That is called the microbes. That is a microorganism. So the microbes or microorganism, it is a very the tiny organism. It is a very tiny or very small organism you cannot see in your eye. How will you see? You can see through under the microscope only. So that is called that microbes or microorganism. Microbes or microorganism. So the microorganism does not have mouth. Okay, that microorganism does not have mouth and digestive system. Then how is it possible? How the digestive system is occur in that microorganism? So that is amazing. Okay, so now we are going to talk about feeding and digestion in amoeba. Feeding and digestion in amoeba. So just you recall, you know the digestion means what? That complex substances is break down into simplest substances. That is called what? Digestion. Okay, so the amoeba. Okay, so amoeba is a microscopic organism. Amoeba is a microscopic organism. It's one of the microscopic organism. Okay, so this organism, where we live, this amoeba, it can survive in the pond water or stagnant water. You know, this amoeba is living in pond water. Amoeba, where we live? The amoeba live in pond water. Amoeba has a cell membrane. You know, amoeba. You know that amoeba. Amoeba has a cell membrane. The amoeba has a cell membrane and rounded. And amoeba has a cell membrane and rounded dense nucleus Okay, ba? So that is a outer layer of the cell membrane. The amoeba has a cell membrane and rounded and the dense nucleus. The rounded in the dense nucleus. Have you understood? And so the amoeba has a many bubble-like structure. Is called vacuole. Is called what? Vacuole. The amoeba has the bubble-like structure. The amoeba has the bubble-like structure. It is called what? Vacuole. Okay. And amoeba has, it is in fact the cytoplasm. Okay. The amoeba, it has the cytoplasm itself. So these all are the parts it present in inside the amoeba. What are the cell membranes and nucleus? Okay, and cytoplasm and the vacuoles. So where is present? The inside the amoeba. Okay, wow. And so these amoeba shape, you know, so the amoeba shape is constantly changed and shape and position. Okay, wow. This amoeba is constantly changed. The constant means what? It's continuously. The amoeba constantly change shape and position. Shape and position. Okay? The amoeba body shape, you know, the body shape is constantly changed. It is not stable shape. Okay, what? That is not, amoeba body shape is not stable. Okay, what? The constantly change and shape and position. Shape and position. Okay, and next is push out one. Is push out one. Which one? Is push out one or more finger-like projection is known as called pseudopodia. Okay, what? The pseudopodia means nothing but more finger-like projection. More finger-like projection. The more finger-like projection, that is called what? The pseudopodia. Called what? The pseudopodia means nothing but the push out. The push out means what? Some food particles. You know, the food particle is push out one, or the more finger like projection. More finger like projection is called pseudopodia. It's called what? Pseudopodia. Okay. And next, what is the main role of the pseudopodia? The pseudopodia is one of the organ. Whichever is one of the parts. So the pseudopodia means nothing but the more finger-like projection is called the pseudopodia. What is the main function of the pseudopodia? Means for movement and capture the food. Movement and capture. Movement and capture the food. That is very important. Two more questions. What is pseudopodia and write the function of pseudopodia. Okay, the pseudopodia means nothing but you pushed out one or more finger-like projection. More finger-like projection is known as called pseudopodia. Okay, what? Pseudopodia or false feet. The pseudopodia or another one name, the false feet. False feet. Okay, what? So what is the main role of pseudopodia on false face mean? It is used for movement and capture the food. It is used for movement. It is used for movement and capture the food. You know that movement means organs are moved from place to place, and capture means they will collect the food. They will get the food. Okay, ba? So it is a main role of the pseudopodia. Okay. And amoeba feeds on some microorganism or microscopic organism. So amoeba what eat? So amoeba is always eat some that microorganism. Okay, wow. So when it that sense food, it push out the pseudopodia. Okay, wow. When that microorganism is fight out the food particle on the pond region. Okay, wow. So that time what will happen? That pseudopodia, you know, the push out pseudopodia around the food particles, around the food particles and engulfs. Okay, so this amoeba, for like amoeba, it can survive in the pond regions. You know, where we will find out the food at the pond region. So amoeba, so like the part of the pseudopodia, you know, so push out. Okay, what? Push out and around the food particles and engulfs. Okay, engulf means nothing but swallow up completely. Vilungudal. Okay, what? Push out and around the food particle and engulfs. Engulf means swallow up completely. Complete up the engulf. That is the meaning of engulfs. Okay. If the food is become trapped in a food vacuum, okay, what figure? See the figure, the 2.10. You know, the food particles or the food become trapped in a food vacuum. In a food vacuum. Next one, the digestive juice. You know, this is very important. The digestive juice is very important. Without digestive juice, the food cannot digest, you know, from multicellular organism to single cellular organism, you know. So the digestive juice, okay, the digestive juice secreted in the food vacuole. Where will the digestive juice secreted? In the food vacuole. Okay, well, the act on the food, the act on the food and break into that simplest substances. It is a common for human being and animal itself. Okay, what? So the process of digestion, you know, all the living organism getting that complex food substances only. So that complex food substances cannot digest. Without digestive juice, the food cannot digest. So what will happen? So the secretes some of the juices. What are the main role of the juices? It will be act and break down in the simplest substances. It act and break down in the simplest substances. Okay. Now the next what will happen? The digestive process over. Next what will happen? The organism, the gradually digested food is absorbed. The digested food is absorbed. Okay, what? So that is a final. That's all. So the digestion means what? The complex food substances is broken into the simplest substances. So that is a digestive process. Okay, what? So now during that process, what will happen? Some of the food materials is transferred from one part of the body to another part of the body. Okay, what? So the absorbed substances are transferred in whole parts of the body. Okay, what? The absorbed substances is provide that what they provide. What are the main uses for growth and maintenance in our body function and that multiplication? Okay. So because the energy is very important, where do you get energy? From the food. Okay, what? So that absorbed substances is provide some of the energy for organism. Have you understood? Without energy, you can't do any work. Okay, what? So that way the food is convert, then we will get some of that substance. That substance is transferred in whole part of the body. So what is the main uses of that substance? That substance used for growth, okay, what? And maintenance the body function and that multiplication. Okay. And last step of the digestion, the undigested residues of the food is expelled. The expelled means remove. Okay, what? The expelled outside by the vacuole. Okay, what? So we will discuss the human digestion. You know, the undigested food material. Okay, what? Undigested food material removed through the anus. So that is the process of human being. Okay, what? In amoeba, you know, so undigested food particle is expelled out by the vacuole. In the vacuole, amoeba, and the undigested food particles when the media one. Okay, what? What is the name of the process? That is the excretion. I told you, know, that is the excretion. Okay, what? So the excretion means what? The waste remove material, the waste food particle remove from the body. That process is called what? Excretion. Okay, what? Or digestion. Okay, what? So in the same process in amoeba itself, So that is the digestive process over. Okay, what? The digestive process, what is the end of the digestive process? The undigested food material or waste material remove. Okay, what? And expel outside by the vacuole. Okay, what? So this is the digestive process is common for multicellular organism to a single celled organism itself. That is a common process. It's a digestive process is a common process for all living organism as well as the microscopic organism itself. Okay, what? So the basic process of digestion of food and energy and release energy in that same in all animals. So nothing but so that process. Okay, what? That digestive process is common for all living organism, especially the multicellular organism to the single cellular organism itself. It is a common process for all living organisms. Okay, what? So that is the end of the topic. Okay, what? So next we will learn about that food substances. Okay, what? that food substances, how they are transported from one pot to another pot. Okay, what? We will learn that next class. What you learn? That food substances, how they are transported from one part of body to another part of the body. Okay? So, that is a feeding and digesting in animal. Okay? That is the second lesson over. You read any doubt, ask. Okay? Thank you.